Hi guys, I'm praying you guys can hear this. I don't want you guys to be fooled. This thing is not moving. Calm down, Shonda, calm down. Okay, I hope this doesn't freeze up again. What I'm about to tell you, blow your mind. Today is still Elul 1. Elul 1 was in the Bible code when he said that calamity, war, because there's been no new moon that was sighted in Jerusalem yet. So technically we're still in Elul 1, you guys. They tried to trick us. If I'm right. I mean, I could be wrong. I mean, I'm only human, man. I'm entitled to be wrong, but what if I'm right? Then if I'm right, then it would be tonight. It would start today. Today is the 23rd. That's why they said that the Black Sky event was going to start the 23rd. It's the day before the 5/8. Oh my goodness. Let's see if we can find that video that I did. I know it's bad, but...
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel. It is 13th. Before I start with my video, I would like to make a quick comment on what I had seen going on my brother Jonathan Matthew Wright's video. This is more a matter of action than it is words. It's more what's going on in this scenario than what's being said. My brother puts his Bible code out and he accessed his Bible.
I'm sorry, guys.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel. It is August 19th, 2017, and today I'm Amos, and only the book of Amos, and you fold it over and write it out so each line has 207 letters in it, you will find America. And
why do you always come out here when I come out here?
Eight of Amos, but to display it,
I did bring you breakfast.
Number divided by two. You can't have half a letter, so you've got to round it up or down. So I rounded it up to 104, and this is what you get. America at an ELS of minus 207, starting in the book of Amos, chapter 9, verse 2. Sorry, the first letter is in chapter 9, but the rest of it is in chapter 8. You got the Aleph in chapter 9, verse 2. Back up, you got the Mem in Amos chapter 8, verse 12. The Resh is in verse 9. The Kuf is in verse 5, and the He is in verse 2. Verse 5 saying, when will the new moon be gone that we may sell raised grain, and the Sabbath that we may set forth wheat, make the ephod small and the shekel great, and falsify the balances by deceit. And right where it says to make great of shekel and to distort of scales of deceit, that's right where it's the kuf is sitting, right in Amos chapter 8 verse 5. It would be right.
So he said, when will the new moon be gone? Okay, the new moon, technically, it wasn't gone. It was still here until today, tonight, or either it starts tomorrow. Either way, what I'm trying to say is, if tonight the new moon is, if it's sighted, the new moon is sighted in Jerusalem, then that means it's Elul 1. I'm trying to find the... I know I did the video on this.
And then the Resh is sitting in verse 9, right at the very end. And it shall come to pass... to that day, saith Yahuwah Elohim, that I will cause the sun to go down at noon, and I will darken the earth in the clear day. And America is encoded right over top of it. It goes right through the center of America. Aleph, Pei, Vav, Lamed. That spells eclipse. And right here, this spells Elul 1. Adam,
Elul
positive enema. You can spell this backwards or forwards, Elul 1, but there it is. It's in the plain text in Amos. Amos 17:16. Now,
don't.
Word of Yahuwah, thou sayest, prophesy not against Israel, and drop not thy word against the house of Isaac.
Something about to happen. And they came trailing.
Wife shall be a harlot in the city, and thy sons and thy daughters shall fall by the sword, and thy land shall be divided by line, and thou shalt die of
Elul 1. It's still Elul 1.
The land, the message
is going down tonight, y'all.
We have
at midnight
eyes of him, Amos. Amos
is going down.
And Amos, you also have as Amos
Elul
over here, and the message.
I'm sorry,
again,
guys, it's still Elul.
From
here, I thought I was wrong, but
N-A,
I guess I'm right.
Amim Bayim, that is an end
right.
time verse. It means,
but
behold,
I wanna go home.
The day has come. America, right? In Amos 8:9, the sun to go down at noon. The sun is right here, and right here you have the black or the dusky. So you have the black sun. The black sun. The solar eclipse is a black sun to the New Age cult.
No, a black sun is coming.
Solar eclipse.
So Elo One, the black son, comes out. He don't realize what he just said. It's still Elo One. That's what they were waiting for. That's why they were taking pictures. You guys gotta understand, this is why they were taking pictures. Because it's Elo One. The dragon should come today, tonight. You guys. Oh, Father. At midnight, remember they moved the clocks one minute closer to midnight. It's going down. It's a lot of helicopters in the sky. It might take 3 days for that zombie virus to go, and on the 21st, 22nd, and 23rd, maybe it takes 3 days for the virus to start replicating and zombifying. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. He said Elo One. It's still Elo One today. I mean, the crescent was not shown in Jerusalem. It's still Elo One, guys. Av 2-9, Elo One is the same. It was a mirror date. We're still in Elo One. And this black sun could come today. Remember it showed the eclipse in the Oreo commercial? Remember it showed the eclipse and then it showed this black red spiraling sun, like it's about to be nasty. Don't fall away, guys. I need everybody on my channel to be fasting right now. Everybody. Don't eat no meat. Just please don't eat no meat. Please don't eat no meat. Don't eat no meat. Don't eat any flesh. Please. Go get you some plant protein powder. Get it on food stamps. I ain't got no food. I'm be all right. My son had a vision. And I didn't know if I should share it or not. And I thought maybe he should share it. But oh, Father. For some reason, in everyone whose visions, this dragon is standing before me, trying to kill me. And my son keeps telling me that, you know, that the evil one knows who I am. He knows I'm an elect, but he knows secretly who I am. And if you guys haven't paid attention to any of my last videos, then you would basically know I confessed to who I was. I am Mary Magdalene. I don't know how this happened. I was chosen from birth. I don't know. I guess I was chosen to wake up at a certain time and warn the masses. But I have the true testimony of Yahuwah and of Yahshua HaMashiach. My Lord, the King of Kings. I'm sorry. It's like I've been in denial for the past months, and you know, I haven't accepted this a while ago, who I am. It's just I've still been in denial after meeting that lady at my job who blessed me with $20. Before she blessed me, she told me, come here, seed of Abraham. Come here and receive this blessing. And I walked over to her, and she shook my hand and she held it. She said, you are the seed of Abraham. The Heavenly Father has so much in store for you. You don't understand. And I told her, I know I am one of the 144,000. I know that I am one of the elect. I have the true living testimony of who Yeshua is and who our Heavenly Father is. I could tell you that Yeshua and our Heavenly Father have both have flames of fire, blue eyes. And that he has hair that goes above his eyebrow. And he has hair that goes down. And he has a full beard, but it's short and nice and neat, just how a king is supposed to be. And she told me that I was very special. And the Father had way more planned for me. I have met Paul Incarnate in Stockbridge, Georgia. I have met King David in Stockbridge, Georgia. I have met a lot of the elect, a lot of the incarnations of our ancestors. I am Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene was black. She was from Ethiopia. And I am her. The Catholic Church spread lies about her. Spread a lot of lies. And it wasn't right what they did. She was delivered from 7 demons that were attacking her in an alleyway when the Messiah saved her. You gotta understand that she was the one who was there when he died. She also was there to witness that he had resurrected. And she also was the first to witness him transformed into the gardener's clothes when she called him Rabboni. And last year, November 2nd, I seen Yeshua, because he is the living image of the Father. So I have seen the Father too. That day, I saw my Lord. And devil, we are going to get this video out. Please bear with me. Very dark. Okay. So, she was there. She was there. She was there the whole time. She was the one who was trying to get the disciples together. And if you remember correctly in the scripture, Peter got mad and he was like, should we listen to this woman? And Levi told him, who are we? If the master left her in charge, who are we to go against that? You know, she understood all the mysteries. I seen him, and these flames were so beautiful, and they were blue, and I mean like a deep blue, like I got lost in him. I love him so much, wholeheartedly, that I would die, I would give my life to serve him. I gave up everything. And I was reading in, I think it was Corinthians, 1 Corinthians. And in Mark, it was saying that the cost of discipleship is to abandon everything. And I've literally abandoned everything, my family, my life, everything, everything that I used to do, I abandoned to follow Christ. I didn't pick up a cross to bear no cross because he didn't die on no cross. He was hung on a tree like every other person in Egypt, in America, this place that you guys call Azareth. I know where we are, I know who we are, and I know what they are coming to do, and I rebuke all of them, and I will be ready for you. I told you guys, I showed you in videos, and I'm going to go and I'm going to find all the links, and I'm going to post all of them below, because I believe that this might be my last video. I don't know. So right now, I just want to ask the Heavenly Father to forgive me if I've committed any sins, if I said anything wrong, to disrespect anybody, anything out of your word, Father. I ask that you just cover me and my children. You just hold us and you just keep us and you just walk with us and everything will be all right, Father. I just want everything. I just want to be with you. I gotta be with you. And there is no place other if I don't have you. You guys could say all day the first person who comes is the Antichrist. The Antichrist has been living amongst us all this time. The son of perdition has been here already. And you guys don't want to accept the truth. The Antichrist is Barack Obama. And I'm not afraid of him. I am not afraid of the Islamic terrorists. I am not afraid to die for my faith and my father, Yahuwah and Yeshua. Yeshua didn't even come in his own name. He came in the name of the Father. Whew, thank you, Father. He said, I come in my Father's name and you perceive me not. And another comes in their name and you don't. And you accept them. But they wouldn't accept Christ and they killed him. They hung him in this land. Don't let them fool you. It was in this land. This is still Egypt. This is Little Egypt, Lower Egypt, whatever you want to call it. This is still Egypt. It's a possibility the Garden of Eden can be in this land. It's a possibility that the Holy Mountain is in this land. It's a possibility. When Christopher Columbus was looking for Jerusalem, he couldn't find it in Africa. He couldn't find it over there. He couldn't find it in the Middle East. So it's a possibility it could be here. I don't know. I've only given you guys the knowledge that I've come across and the power behind it and the scripture proves that we've been lied to, that we've been tricked, we've been duped. We are about to inherit our Abraham's land. The great Exodus is getting ready to occur. We'll never leave our land again. I am the woman of Revelation chapter 12. Mary Magdalene. It is so hard to accept this, but I have to. My beloved is coming. I have to tell everything right now because I have the true testimony. I don't know when. I don't know when. What time. And that Obama and all his demons, that dragon will come. But he's coming for everyone who has a true testimony. And I've been on several people's pages that have the true testimony. One is Prophet Among Us, even though I've never seen his face. But he talk about our people having the flames of fire blue eyes. I know he is true because only the true people know that. We already know that Yeshua was of Hebrew color. We already know he had bronze skin. We knew this already. So this is not up for discussion that he was a Negro. There's nothing up for discussion in this. So you got to understand that. Okay, yes, he had flames of fire, blue eyes. He had fair hair. The scriptures say that he had wool. But what I seen was like fair hair. It wasn't like, I don't know, like not mine. But it was like kept up though. So, and the moments coming up, we're going to see everything for what it truly is. And I don't know when the power is going out. So I have to do this now. Christ hung on a tree. He did not die on a cross. They pierced his side. And you who pierce his side, you will pay. Those who lead into captivity will go into captivity. And then a lot of people who are outside watching the eclipse from the beginning to the end will turn into zombies. I'm so sorry. I warned you guys not to go out. That they were... NASA was floating in the air 50 balloons of alien bacteria. They're going to turn you guys into zombies. I'm so sorry. If you're not one of the elect and if you don't have the true testimony of Yahuwah, you won't be saved. So if you don't have Yahuwah, please repent. Come back to the Father. Seek Him. Seek His face. Seek understanding. Seek the Holy Spirit. Seek Yahshua because He is the door. The door shall be open unto you. It was open unto me. I'm telling you, I seen the door. I seen the door. I have the true testimony. I watched this door open to me after one was closed. I watched it appear next to the closed one. I watched it appear closed and I watched it open. And the light shines like no other from behind it. I'm telling you, I have the true testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. I've been to the place of the two candle menorah sticks. And in Revelation, in the earlier chapters, I think it's in chapter 3 or chapter 2, one of the churches that said that it will remove your candlestick. I have two candle menorah sticks, one for Christ and one for me. My cup runs over. I have a living Holy Spirit that lives inside of me. It has literally kept me from being in a relationship with a guy who was an abuser, who tried to claim that he was an elect, but he was an imposter. And she's clothing this is before I found out who I was. And once he found out that I was royalty, and that I didn't belong to him and I belonged to the king, he felt some kind of way. I am set apart. I am about to go away for 1,260 days. I don't know exactly when this started, but everything is pointing to now, the first of Elul. Soon as we see the zombies, we leave. Understand, you should be in repentance right now. I'm going to post this to every social media site that I have right now. It's about to die. Right now, I want to seal this up in Yahuwah's name, in the Heavenly Father's name, and in Yahshua's name, my Baha Hashem. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being here with me. Thank you for being here this long. I will try to do another video. The dragon is coming. I showed you the pictures. NASA's taking pictures of him. He's coming down. He's descending. He's coming. I have the true testimony of Yahuwah. And I have no fear. I know that if I die, which I know I can't die, but if I was to die, my Father would come and pick up my body himself and resurrect me. I'm telling you, he delivered us in his hand. He carried us to the holy mountain in his hand. He is who he is. He is the Almighty. I love you guys all much. Shalom. May the Heavenly Father be with you. May he keep you and your family and all your friends. And may he bless you for what is getting ready to happen tonight.